Hello, everyone. I'm Nathan Newbrough, and I'm the CEO of the Colorado Springs Philharmonic, here with, and I'm a little starstruck, with Michael Cavanaugh in person, star performer of Rocket Man, the music of Elton John, coming up with the Colorado Springs Philharmonic October 21st and 22nd. And we just can't wait for you to arrive. We want you to be really welcome here. Michael, thank you for coming.
Thrilled to be coming. I love Colorado. I love Colorado Springs. Been there many times and can't wait to play with your symphony. It's going to be awesome.
It's such an inspired show, but you know, reading through your bio, we haven't met before. I can't wait to meet you in person. Reading through your bio, Elton John, not your first inspiration.
Well, I mean, it was close. Yeah. It was very close. So yeah, Billy Joel was first, but I mean, Elton was probably the next day. You know, I grew up on both of them. A lot of people know me for singing Billy Joel songs because I was in the Broadway show Moving Out. So we did launch a Music of Billy Joel show that we do with symphonies, and we'd love to come back and do that one with you guys as well in the future. We do the Elton John show. We launched the Elton John show second, and we do that one all over the place. We do it a ton, and we love it, and can't wait to do it in Colorado Springs.
Yeah. Well, talk to us. Give us a portrait of the artist as a young man. Right. So you started piano very young.
Yeah. My parents bought a piano when I was 7 years old. Mm-hmm. And I just attacked the thing the first day. Like, you couldn't get me off of it. God bless them and my brothers for listening to that all day for 5 hours a day, nonstop. You know, it didn't necessarily sound great at the beginning, but I was just taken over by it, you know, and I just played and played and played and played.
Yeah. Yeah. And you had a sort of a discovery moment. I got to read this because every piano bar should be named the Blazing Pianos.
Blazing Pianos was a cool place. Yeah.
You were playing at Blazing Pianos and something happened.
Well, actually Blazing Pianos was before that. I played in Blazing Pianos in Orlando.
Yeah.
It was in New York Hotel and Casino in Vegas where something happened.
Actually, That's where it happened. Okay. Tell us what it's all about then.
Well, it started with, I became friends with Billy Joel's tour manager, Max Lubier. He saw me at the piano bar in there. And that alone was very exciting to me. And I thought maybe one time in my life I'd get to shake Billy Joel's hand and I would feel like my life was complete. Well, a couple months after I met Max, I knew Billy was coming into town with Elton when they were touring together for a show. And I knew I was going to go. I was hoping maybe to get backstage, but I didn't know Billy was in town a couple of days early. So Max calls me before before I'm getting ready to go to work, like 15 minutes before. And he said, "Hey, I'm in town with Billy and we are coming to see you." Gotta turn something off here. "We are coming to see you tonight in the piano bar." And I'm trying not to have a heart attack, right? I'm completely losing my mind. So I went there and he came to the piano bar and he loved it. And that's kind of where everything started. Billy liked me and, you know, I went to that show, many shows, and hung out with him backstage and he was so nice. And a couple months later is when I heard about this idea for a Broadway show. They didn't have a name for it yet.
Yeah.
They said, "Would you be willing to fly to New York and meet Twyla Tharp?" Twyla was the choreographer. She was the director. She was the one that took all of Billy's songs and made a story out of it. So yeah. I went to New York and I met her and kind of all went from there. I was able to do that show on Broadway for 3.5 years starting that show. And that's probably the reason I know you right now. That's the reason I get to do these amazing gigs I do now.
Yeah, well, we can't wait for you to come here. So I people will have lots of questions for you. What's the question about your performance style that you get the most? What's the question about this performance?
Well, people always ask me, like, what's your favorite song to perform? You know, what's your favorite? And with Elton,
yeah.
The funnest song for me to do is a song called Honky Cat. I love the piano style, the whole, you know, I just love that stuff. Right. So when I heard that as a kid, I was like, what is that? How do I do that? How do I do that? Yeah, I was probably like 7 or 8 when I heard that song. Yeah. I was like, how do I play like that? And, you know, it's Elton really inspired me as a piano player when he plays that type of stuff.
Yeah.
I mean,
yeah.
I love all that stuff, yeah, right? But yeah. that kind of honky tonk thing he does is just so cool.
Is that from his? That's from the Honky Chateau album.
Yeah.
I think
that. Yeah. You know.
We had that growing up.
And obviously,
LP, yes.
Oh, yeah, we had that. Of course, we had Goodbye Yellow Brick Road, which is, you know, can't get more classic than that. And we had Don't Shoot Me on the Piano Player. Is that what it's called? We had all these albums, right? Mm-hmm. We had all the Billy Joel albums, all these Elton John albums. We had Simon and Garfunkel albums. We had all this great music all over the house. And we had the LPs, and you would open them up, and I would read all the credits. And, it was different back then.
Right.
It was different.
Right. So as a performer of Elton John's music, what's something that you think people don't appreciate or don't know about Elton John's career or his music?
Well, I tell you the one song that some people don't know, the diehard fans know, that we do in the show, but a lot of other people, if you say Funeral for a Friend, Love Lies Bleeding, they might not recognize it. And it kind of takes Elton, kind of shows his classical influences.
Yeah.
And it starts on the album with this big synthesizer intro, but we have the orchestra play it, and it's amazing. And to me, it shows his diversity musically, like how far he can go. And Elton, I mean, think of all the albums he's made over the years, all the hits he's had. And he's still to this day, I mean, I think he has the number one song right now with Britney Spears, right? It's called Hold Me Closer. So it's a remix of Tiny Dancer. But he's a genius. Like he had a number one hit 2 months ago or whatever with Dua Lipa, which was called Cold Cold Heart. It was a remix of Sacrifice.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
He is so good at staying plugged in. You talk to little kids, they know who Elton John is. They all know I'm Still Standing. They all know Rocket Man. You know, it's just, there's no one else like him. There's no one else like Elton.
Yeah. Well, thanks for bringing his music to us. Could we hear a little something extra?
Sure.
You? Yeah.
Give me a little taste. All right. I'm not that warmed up, but I think I can do it. Here we go.
It's a little bit funny, this feeling inside. I want to know who can easily hide away. Don't have much money, but if I did, I'd buy a big house where we both could live. And if I was a sculptor, but then again, or a man makes potions on a traveling shore. I know it's not much, but it's the best I can do. My gift is my song, and this one's for you. You can tell everybody this is your song. Baby, quite simple, but now that it's done,
everybody at home sing along, come on.
I hope you don't mind that I put down words. How wonderful life is, you're in the world.
All right.
Michael Cavanaugh, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Have a blast.
We will have a blast October 21st and 22nd, Friday and Saturday night at the Pikes Peak Center for the Performing Arts. All the details are at csphilharmonic.org. Michael Cavanaugh, you're amazing. Thanks for spending this time with us. We can't wait to see you.
All right. We'll see you soon.